You are the love of my life.
a request for us to pray together. So I feel I would be happy to lead us all in a group prayer, and then really the gratitude in our hearts, the song of thanks that we sing in our hearts, and our happiness is really what is most, you might say, most pleasing to spirit, is us to be happy, us to be the way we were created, is the greatest, most honoring, respectful prayer that you can ever have. Your happiness is a gift to the whole universe. So I think I will lead this in a prayer, and then I think Francis was really feeling strongly of sharing just this deep sense of gratitude. And then Francis can maybe kick that off, and we can pass the microphone around if anyone wants to add their voice to our prayer as we send this to the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, thank you for giving us this opportunity to heal, to expand our awareness of the miracle and of forgiveness. Thank you for guiding us with so many holy encounters and songs, movies, talks, quiet time in nature, to bask in your presence and be showered with your love. This, for us, is our new beginning. We have come together to be led by you, to be activated and used in the plan of awakening. We prayed early on for spectacular miracles, and we know that you will give us those miracles. You will perform miracles through us if we are willing, if we step forward and say yes to your invitation. These days have been a time to let all emotions come to the surface, and we are grateful that we have had these opportunities. Lead us in the way of miracle thinking. Lead us to all good habits of thinking with you and being your instruments and your messengers. We are at a crossroads in our mind. The journey that we have taken before is over now, and we begin anew with fresh determination, with a strong desire to have the healing in our mind that we may bless everyone in the world. Amen.
I would like to share my gratitude of the last 5 days. First, that Chris was very persistent in inviting us over. And blessing it has been for the whole universe, you know, such a blessing. I feel I do want to share this funny story that I recently, David and I went to visit this friend that we met a couple of years ago, and she started this business of working with a quantum machine, and she tested out with us, and she hooked it up onto me, and she was, you know, doing some readings on the quantum machine. You know, I don't know, it's just called quantum machine. It doesn't do anything. Yeah, it just quantum. It picks up something.
Your first time.
It didn't ask me any questions though. It just and she said the machine picked up that you had these autistic patterns. And I was like, what is autistic? And she said, you know, close down when you feel not safe, you know, like a child that is autistic, they close themselves in a room instead of going out to communicate. So I thought, I've never heard that as a description of me, but ever since that, I started to have all these memories came to me. Like, this is a way of coping with this world that I use all throughout the lives, especially the early part where when there was intense emotions coming up, what did I do? Shut down. Push people away. You know, hide. Stop communication. You know, people that I feel I don't know how to handle, shut down communication. If I don't know how to handle an emotion in an intimate relationship, push them away, stop talking to them for a few days. You know, that's the kind of mechanism that feels safe somehow. Insanely, that feels very safe to the ego is to close down, shut down and push people away. Then you see whether you come out or not, you know. So I thought, wow, I'm glad that what happened in these past few years was, you know, it's really a way of opening up in a way that is you actually started to see how I have been doing this to myself. You know, pushing people away and pushing anything away and hiding becomes very, very painful. But this is what I used to think is called life. You build a private family, a private house, a private circle of friends for what? For safety. Or ease of connection, so that there are certain people you don't have to include because it's not really pleasant or safe. You know, I was very selective or private in the way that I deal with the world or with people, and had fear of being in a large group or not knowing what to say. And, you know, but what really happened was, like David was saying this morning, it wasn't that I had to let go of certain things. What was really happening is I had to find a way to include more and more, and eventually the whole universe come to my world. But in doing that, I had to allow myself to step out of a very comfortable to the ego, but very limited box, so that I could choose to open up on a daily basis to allow people who are sent by the Spirit to come to my world and allow myself to open up in that way. And that is what we have been practicing in the community, because there was no way I can hold on to a grievance and hide from people and stay angry, you know, and stay closed down. It just not able to happen that way. So it kind of really pushed me to learn to really communicate with people in the present moment, open my heart up, and really wash away all these layers and layers of attack thoughts. So today, I think especially I had a few people in the morning and at lunch brought up this this topic of loneliness. And I really want to say that in a way that, you know, this world, the way that we, you know, live in this world as separate individuals is what loneliness is. You know, the loneliness comes from this deep sense of we're separate. And there is a way of healing this deep sense of loneliness. And the way to undo that is actually very simple. It's through reaching out. Reaching out. So here in this closing, I really want to say that I'm grateful for myself. Somehow the Spirit find a way for me to reach out. And I'm grateful that you also give yourself the gift to reach out and allow yourself to be here with so many people for the, you know, 24/7 for these last 5 days. And you all know the gift that has been. And I also heard some people ask, well, it feels good to be here, feel good to do expression sessions here, but there is no way I could feel the same way when I go back home. But I also feel, you know, even here, you have all kinds of emotions come up. You have, you know, joy and trust and heart-opening experiences, but also in that you feel safe enough. Actually, maybe anger came up, frustration, irritation, and all of those emotions were permitted to come up as well. But you feel okay to allow them to come up. You feel supported. You feel there is a way that you can handle it here because there is a lot of support and there is a trust in the mind. So I just feel like there is no need to stop. We won't stop from here anymore. You know, we're going to continue on with this momentum of knowing how much we need each other, and we're going to keep reaching out. So that's our invitation. Our email, my email, Jenny's email, and Jenny's Skype, and our website, Spreaker, put on the board is a huge invitation. Please write to us. You know, if you don't find anyone nearby that you can open, write to us, and we're with you all the way. We're with you every step of the way. You know, we need each other.
Wow. Thank you.
I thought about the attitudinal healing that's already here in Holland and in Germany also, I know. And it's exactly the expression sessions as we did it here, just listening with open hearts and no comments. So if you look for a group, look at the side of the Course in Miracles or From Heart to Heart, and there you can find a group in probably next to your place.
Yeah, so I thought we, you know, we can just share and leave it open as well to use the next hour and a half, perhaps, just if you have an overflowing sense of gratitude or anything that you feel that you really want to share with the whole group, we want to hear it.
There is also a miracle
After the last session, a couple came up to me and shared that they have a place here in Holland and a place in Portugal, and they would like to offer it for a retreat. So it sounds like in December we will have a week or 5 days or a week. We will, all the details will come in the time to come, but in Portugal to start with. So we will share the information about that when it's ready.
And also we have not there. We also had a list of participants there. It's not because of that, but anyway, if your name is on that, your name is not yet on it, you can put your name on it. And at least you will get the participant list. Because Jan says he will do that.
I will put this again.
He will send everybody the participant list.
Right. In case you want to contact each other.
Yeah, that has nothing to really with this suggestion, but it can also have to do with it. We can also give you information on that.
Great, so everyone who wants to share your email address with each other, this is the paper to write it on. I think you have it for us, right?
I would like to share my gratitude. I came here because I wanted to connect with people that are living the Course in Miracles. Because for me, it has been always separate compartments in my life. The Course in Miracles, reading it and feeling the miracles, but then stepping into my life again and having a fight with my husband, not being able to really apply it all day long, and I found living examples in you, which is really inspiring, and I am sure it will. It's a stone in a pond, and it will go on and on and on. And I really pray to be able to apply more in my own life. And this touches me because I phoned my husband. I wanted to connect, and really simple and. I could hear him crystal clear, and I felt love. It was a call out of love, but also for love. And he couldn't understand me, and it's really symbolic. And I really want to transform that. I must create it myself, and it's like a chewing gum. I chewed on it for too long. I want to spit it out. Thank you very much for your inspirational for this
example. Before I don't dare anymore. When I came in, I expressed that I wanted to have a coach to face my fears and bring them to the light and surrender to this path. And as she said, you are all okay. I'm making a blanco. Yeah, you're so inspirational for me. And I had fears, and I faced them. One of the fears was I didn't dare speak to you, and I felt jealousy to Slava, who you were talking to. And I sat down the next morning and I wrote it down and I saw what was happening. And this morning at breakfast, we talked it over with a few people. So I was also there. And then the tears came because my greatest fear, and I'm getting emotional again, is especially with you, David, that I will be exposed, that you can see through me and So I thought about it, and I thought, I'm afraid of my own light. That's my problem. And I'm so grateful that that this came up.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's nothing more to say. I'm just grateful. Thank you all.
Will you start me again? Many times a week. It's beyond, and I didn't have any expectation, but even if I had them, it is beyond. And the inclination that I'm feeling since such a long time has been confirmed. And as I expressed at the beginning of this week, I want it all. And I give it all. Because there's no way back. And it's even stronger than at the beginning of this week. I really know now. And this is it. There's no other way. This is it. I want this. So I will see how my life will unfold and try to listen to my best abilities at this moment. But Holy Spirit is guiding me through. And when Marianne was singing, I even could feel the possibility of leaving my mother behind if the Holy Spirit is calling me for that. And I also know, despite I'm only child, and my father is dead since a long, long time, I remember that she already said, if you are guided to leave me, although I'm old and sick, I will not resist it, because I know you do it for God, and I know that I will be taken care of.
Wow.
I suddenly remembered that. But somehow she might know it intuitively that something is coming up, I don't know.
But God's with you.
But anyway, there are no words. It's beyond words and all the love that all the people here. I feel so rich and so happy and so connected to all of you. Thank you so much for this amazing experience. Thank you all. Thank God. Say something. It's a scary thing to say, but I'm going to say it. In front of you all, I want to thank my own spirit for being persistent in knowing that I had to be here and taking the space. And thank you all for sharing and being beautiful mirrors of Holy Spirit, and bless you all, and you're all amazingly beautiful. Thank you.
I want to thank you so much. It was such a great week, and I really can feel as if my vibration has raised, been a higher vibration now, and I hope I can keep it. But it was really great. I had not expected it actually that this week would be like this. The love you show, the love you live, and the field of love with everybody. It's just so beautiful to feel connected in such a field of love. I thank you so much, everyone over here with whom I could share this week. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I love you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Well, long drive we are making this week. I feel it like God is taking me by his hand. So I think this is so new to me. I came in here unexpected for me, myself as well. So I thank God and well, let's see what brings this to me.
I'm so grateful. You're such beautiful examples of transparency and love and guided by spirit. You really show me new ways of relating with myself and relating with God and also relating with everyone. Because there's also that what you said, that loneliness I feel always when I go in this world and relate to myself and relate to my brothers. And now you really opened up ways for me to go further on this and be connected again. So I'm so grateful for that. Thank you. Thank you for knowing you. You're always in my heart. Thank you for knowing me.
Last year, I was one day when we were the weekend here in Holland, and I came the second day, and I was too late. And at the movies, I couldn't keep my eyes open, and I thought, "What are all those girls doing on the stage? I came for David." So I wasn't having a lot of rejection. But now, I promised myself to start all over again and a bit more open-minded, really. And now I'm so glad with all the girls on stage that David, you may stay. And it's what I heard before. Since a few months, I really think I've read enough books. Instead of reading all those spiritual books, I keep on doing the course, though. But I want to live it. I want to live it now. Now it's time to start living it. And you are such examples. So that really is giving to me.
I really met love on another level, and it's really amazing. It's such so precious love, more than personal love. It's a great gift, and I bring it on. I will. Thank you so much.
in the beginning of the retreat, I thought that I was not connected to the Holy Spirit and that I was lonely, but during the week I realized that I have more contact with the Holy Spirit than I thought. And I see now all the moments the Holy Ghost called me and that I listen to His call, and so it gives me a lot of trust in my relationship with Jesus. And so thank you. And even I listened to His call to be here because I live in a community, and I was curious about how do you live the Course in Miracles. And now you are my examples. And I like to visit one of your communities, but I don't know them. But I will come. I think it will be Mexico.
Thank you.
I met you last year in Amsterdam underneath a tree, and I immediately knew that I wanted to see you again. So when I heard of this retreat, I had to sign up immediately. So I'm very grateful to be here. And you told such lovely things about the world. It made it so clear to me that I can laugh about it and just be happy. So it's perfect fire to open my heart more, and well, it did this week. So thank you all for all your help. It's really lovely. Thank you.
I already expressed to various people my gratitude for being here and seeing living miracles the whole day in front of me with you here. And this week has, I so strongly feel it has enhanced my dedication to the Holy Spirit, to the work, to... I said this afternoon, I don't know where I'll be next year, but I'm open for everything that
I
do. Thank you very, very much for your practical teachings. It's really fantastic. Thank you.
I've learned this week to express myself without feeling ashamed. And I'm really grateful for the way you speak about the ego, David. Such a lot of laughter. It makes it so easy, so light. So, well, it's very helpful. It's very, very helpful. Thank you so much. Thank you all.
David, as you said, that joyfulness is the best prayer. My soul is singing this whole morning. Singing soul. A little bit strange. I lack it. I lack it.
I have some in my soul.
He's got a song in his heart.
So now we all know that, therefore we are here to talk about the life and to have love to each other. And for me it was very essential that the whole week I had not one moment the idea that I was wrong. And that's new. You didn't try to change me. So I'm really sure there is hope for me.
That's adorable.
I wasn't going to say anything, but I can't lie, so... Well, it's all been said before, but I thank you for this week, and so happy you came here, close to our homes, and I hope to visit you in Spain, maybe soon, maybe later. I'm happy that it's very close to Holland, not all the way to America. And I'm so happy to meet all those new friends, all the love that was here. And yeah, my heart is, how is it? Flowing over, over joy. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I was not going to say something. Thank you very much, all of you. It was a big inspiration. I was very glad to find out. I couldn't believe that you came to school. It was a big surprise. I read it over and over, and I thought that this must have been last year. This is unknown, but no. I signed in, and it was a big... it's a big gift for me because it's just before I go back to South Africa. I live in South Africa as well. So, in a couple of weeks. So, I'm so grateful and happy to meet all of you, and especially you. And, well, thank you. It was a big inspiration from the bottom of my heart.
I only want to add my compliments for your great talent in storytelling.
When I met Jesus first time, it was like this golden wave going through my body, and it was like, it was just this pure embracing and understanding. It was just understanding. I didn't only like 1 year later I realized, no, not yet, very much later I realized that it was love. Like the first time in my life I touched love, or love touched me, or whatever. And this non-judgmental embracement, that was when I saw you on YouTube, I thought, yeah, that's it. That finally, that's it. And that was the story where I came here, and it's so beautifully unfolding. It's like you push out these waves over every one of us, and it's like it's no one can be, everyone can tell whatever he wants. And there's no judgment, that's just love coming over. You can tell something and you just, the reply is always love. Yeah. That's it. And I must say, I enjoy it. Like, for me, it was like I saw the messages and I thought, wow! That's beautiful! And that's also, I want to thank everyone. It's amazing, like, that's beauty, but also the wisdom. Now the wisdom is really pouring through for everyone, and that's so beautiful, and it's a really big blessing. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yes, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for this week. It was really amazing. I'm really touched and really, yes. And you know, I come from a Buddhist practice, so I love to see also beside Christ a really inspiring laughing Buddha showing movies.
Yes.
That was great for me. Yes, I enjoyed it very much, and to be with you all was a great experience, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
Yeah, I want to thank Jesus for everything that he does. And being here and bringing me here. As always, I didn't know why I was coming here, but it's always so beautiful just to join in the healing with everybody, and to be in the brotherhood is just, yeah, there's no real words for it. And just to see the healing taking place is pretty wonderful. And I was just like reflecting and just thinking it's so beautiful to have those beautiful reflections back at me. Yeah, I'm just so grateful for everybody here. And I feel really, really welcomed here. So yeah, thank you so, so much, one and all.
It has given me a lot of trust to find out that although my ego is saying that I'm at the wrong place, that I'm always on the right place. Thank you.
I am very grateful for when I came here and said I am jealous that people that dare to expose themselves on YouTube. But it's really my longing to expose myself totally to the Holy Spirit, which I did, and also to the brother, like this exercise, one-to-one exercise, and yeah, just shit. It's so safe to do so. I also felt like being afraid there's no bottom when we there's no ground when we did this exercise, and my brother, the Holy Spirit, stays there in the light. I don't know how to explain, but it's like it's not a bottom, not a ground I wanted, but it doesn't need to be. It's just this, it's not a really blank, but it's, well, hoe zeg ik dat? It's not needed. It's I can totally trust it. I can totally trust it. I'm discovering it. And I also like to say that if any one of you wants to continue practicing this one-to-one, I'm into it on Skype or something.
Yeah, I really want to thank you for this
a long time I had a longing to make, to do a weekend or a week with you. I saw it once in Hawaii, so I asked a friend, oh, let's go to David. She said, all the way there, and so expensive, so I didn't dare to do it alone. So when I saw it here, I said, I have to do it. He's coming all the way to Holland, and I'm so happy that I participated. I did the questionnaire is an endeavor academy, it's a different way, like, you know, teaching. And coming here, it's a different way, but it's so loosening up me, you know, the ties, the controls, and I had resistance, and I made the shift from being resistant to being totally happy to participate. And also the movies, not the movie, what you see, what it's done to me. So I said, wow, it's just, it happens to me in different ways. So I was really happy. And even in my dream, I could see that I want structure and things. And I could see it was loosening. So that's what happened with me here. It's just loosening this. And while you were sharing, Helen, about your way, your road, it's just, I have it, then it just takes me in this energy. I could feel this freedom and going through it. It's like it comes in me, you know? It's like, and also you with your sound, and the fear, and then you're going through it. Oh, they land well, so I'm landing well. You know, it's just great to have you here and to experience this all. And from David, I saw you on the internet, and so this wisdom, but knowing you and all these teachings, it's even more, it's so deep, the wisdom, and I just would like to have more and more and more, you know? It's true, because even the movies, I was thinking, how is he getting this? When they say it, you know, I know this is sparse, like the one of yesterday, but you're taking more and more out of it, and I'm totally here. It's just great to have someone like this in the question, because then I want to continue, you know, so maybe I'll be in, how do you call it, in Spain, because I really love to continue it on a daily basis, because I don't want to lose it anymore. It's just, it has to be my daily breath. I'm really very happy with the way you are and the way you, for the example. It's really an example for me. Mm. And also the things you went through, you know, what you were telling. And I'm very happy that this week I experienced it. Thank you so much. Really, thank you. And thank you all the other friends also. Thank you so much.
Jenny, thank you so much to represent the light, one light of the world. I bless you with all my heart, and I love you so much.
Yeah, well, what can I say? Thank you again. I came here to in life feel the presence of all you guys. I know you through YouTube since maybe 6-7 months, and I must say that to meet you in real life and feel you and watch you is amazing and a great inspiration. And an example of nothing through can be threatened, and nothing here can be threatened, and nothing unreal exists. Mm-hmm. I guess. You were just demonstrating that to the Buddhist. Simple remark. And another big, oh, that wasn't a surprise. I supposed it, but it extended my didn't but the big surprise for me is actually meeting all my brothers in this course, because this is the first time I am together with people that seek something of what we all think. Hmm? And it was a mind-blowing experience to meet you all. Thank you.
I also want to really say thank you. I'm thinking. Just a few years ago, I was really like felt like a total outcast, and was a first person, and at least in my hometown. So, and just the thought of being here and opening up, and feeling at home. And I want to thank Jesus and for taking my hand and showing me the safe way home and the answer to everything. Thank you all. And when I look back, that people say, "Oh, thank you for organizing this. It looks really strange. I don't really recognize the me that has done this sort of thing. It's more like watching by." And then I said, "Well, I guess this is probably what I've been praying for, you know, just being able to do this." So I'm so thankful, you know, also having the opportunity to work with you guys. It's been so special. I hope I will continue doing this. You never know. I'm not going to pinpoint anything right now, but it will stay open. And but it's definitely been worthwhile. But
Holy Spirit continuously, and the answer immediately. that you are of spiritual energy, love, insight, examples, and so on, and so on. And he gave me specific answers. And he promised me that he will be with me when I'm home. Thank you.
My heart is full of gratitude, and I had so many insights, and been so inspired, but now I can't cope anymore. Do we continue one more hour with the gratitude? I fell asleep, I want to run out. I'm so tired. I can't sit still and open the window or whatever. Do you have an answer for me?
Yeah, I think we're getting close to maybe going out and finding a nice open space so we can have a big group hug.
Yeah.
And I can bring my phone out so I can take all your smiling, happy faces out in the green grass and the trees so people can be inspired by all that you shared and all that we went through. So I think that's a good symbol that it's time for us to go out into nature and have a big hug together.
Yeah, thank you.
Before we go, I also just wanted to say thank you all. And the big word I hear or see in my mind with big letters, willingness. It's just thank you for your willingness. It's so, that's, we wouldn't be here without you. So this is, yeah, it's so beautiful. And I want to just encourage everyone who also has received some nudges and inspirations from this retreat, just to go for it and go for the things that you may be a little scared of or that you may think you don't dare to do, but go for the communications and the things that you have felt. You're all so beautiful.